Hi, my dear children, good morning. Let us start our second module of the topic Nazism and the Rise of Hitler. We had discussed about Allied power, Axis power, and the suicide of Adolf Hitler with his family. Germany, a powerful empire in the early years of 20th century, fought the First World War alongside the Austrian Empire and against the Allies. As we know, the First World War broke out in the year 1914 and ended in 1918. England, France and Russia were the major three countries in the Allied group. All joined the war enthusiastically, hoping to gain from a quick victory. Little did they realize that the war could stretch on, eventually draining Europe of all its resources. Germany made initial gains by occupying France and Belgium. However, the Allies, strengthened by the US entry in 1971, defeating Germany and the Central Powers in November 1980. The defeat of Imperial Germany and the abdication of the Emperor gave an opportunity to parliamentary parties to recast German polity. A National Assembly met at Weimar and established a democratic constitution with a federal structure. Deputies were now elected to the German Parliament, Reichstag, on the basis of equal and universal votes cast by all adults, including women. The Republic means Weimar Republic, however, was not received well by its own people, largely because of the terms it was forced to accept after Germany's defeat at the end of the First World War. The peace treaty at Versailles with the Allies was a harsh and humiliating peace. Germany lost its overseas colonies, a tenth of its population, 30% of its territories, 75% of its iron, and 26% of its coal to France, Poland, Denmark, and Lithuania. The elite power demilitarized Germany to weaken its power. The war guilt clause held Germany responsible for the war and damages the elite countries suffered. Germany was forced to pay a compensation amounting to 6 billion pounds. The elite armies also occupied the resource-rich Rhineland for much of the 1920s. Many Germans held the new Weimar Republic responsible for not only the defeat in the war, but the disgrace at Versailles. In other words, we can say that all the burden of the humiliating peace treaty called the Treaty of Versailles came there on the shoulder of the newly formed Weimar Republic. The war had a devastating impact on the entire continent, both psychologically and financially. From a continent of creditors, Europe turned into debtors. Unfortunately, the infant Weimar Republic, the newly formed Weimar Republic, was being made to pay for the sins of the old empire. As I told you, as you were told, all the burden at last came there on the shoulder of the Weimar Republic. The Republic carried the burden of war guilt and national humiliation and was financially crippled by being forced to pay compensations. Those who supported the Weimar Republic, mainly socialists, Catholics and Democrats, became easy target of the attack in the conservative nationalist circles. They were mockingly called the November criminals. This mindset had a major impact on the political developments of the early 1930s in Germany. Hi children, hope you have understood this fact. We are going to stop for the time being, and the remaining parts will be discussed in our next class. Thank you.